Alright, chat, today we are getting into how I made $1 million developing video games. You're gonna see every step I took in my game development journey prior to making my first $1 million. I started out making mediocre games that nobody cared about, and then I went up to making games that got 9 out of 10 averages, hit after hit after hit, and I ended up making $1 million. I'm gonna show you how I did it in this video. Before we get into it though, before I show you how I made $1 million, are you subscribed? You check? Did you really check you're subscribed? All right, I'll take your word for it. Let's get into it. This is how I made $1 million with a couple of indie games. If you want to break it down, you can say that there was one really big game that made me my first $1 million, but you're gonna have to watch the video and see what it is. I can't tell you right now. All right, let's get into it. I make video games. You sell video games. You make lots of money. And you build up your studio, and that's literally the entire game. All right, get my company name. We're gonna be Ubisoft, in brackets, but good. My name, John Ubisoft. All right, so we're ready. We're gonna develop a new game. The topics we have: transport, simulation, I'm gonna call it. Train galore. Not so much anything in story and quest, but we're gonna bump up gameplay a lot, and also the engine. So you can like tweak certain elements of your game, and then you wanna have like, ideally, you don't know starting off, but you wanna have like the perfect game where it's like just enough gameplay and just enough like design, and then like you wanna have a good genre with a good simulation. Basically the whole thing is trial and error, and then you make lots of money, and then you get bigger and better studios, and you can like hire people to build a game. It's crazy. All right, the reviews for Trains Galore are in. We got, starting off with a 5, it's not terrible. Starting off with a 7, it's not terrible. 5, okay. And a 6, that's not bad. That's actually really not bad. That's pretty good. We are all above, or if not at 5. We got 5,000 units in the first week. This is an important milestone in the history of Ubisoft, but good. We sold 10K of our game. We can do a like reflection. So this will kind of tell us like, this will add notes into the game that's like, hey, this goes good with this. I also just realized that the sound's off. Whoops. So it'll now, like, it'll tell me this when I go to make a game that's transport and simulation. We're gonna develop a new game. Actually, we have some research points. So you can use research points to kind of like find new topics, and like eventually when you start building your own engines, you can like your own game engines, you can use it towards that. So my idea is we do a romance sim. And we're gonna call it Get Out of Your Basement. Meet a Real. Ah, I can't do Meet a Real Woman. I can't. Whatever. Call it Get Out of Your Basement Sim. It's gonna cost 30K. Story and quests aren't that big of a deal. Yeah, okay, we can kind of keep it like this, I guess. Sound, graphics, world design. I feel like world design might not be that important. Nintendo is launching their newest console. So basically, like, you'll have rival companies. They're not really rival companies, but like there will be companies that create like platforms for you to develop on, and then you kind of have to find which ones are popular and all that. But you have to have the license to develop for that console. I think we're ready to launch our new game. And here are the reviews. Here we go. All right, let's see. Starting off with a 7. Not terrible. Starting off with a 5. This person gave it a 6. Ooh, 5, all right, not bad. Go to develop a new game and then see what genres we have. Adventure, action. Okay, hold on. Let's research hunting. And then let's do a hunting action game. Animal poacher. Hold on. Let's say 1998. I was trying to go along the lines of like NBA 2K, and then I realized that this is set right now in like the 80s, like maybe the 70s. I don't really know. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, the entertainment system. All right, here we go. Here's the reviews. No way. Oh my god, I thought I was gonna get like a 9 right off the bat. Wow, okay, this game is actually like pretty decent. Okay, we're gonna immediately research something new. Hack. Attack. Oh my god, I'm so, dude, holy. I don't know where I pulled that from. What is this? I just finished Animal Poacher 1986 and I'm impressed by your talent. I'm in the contract and business where you use skills. Okay. So yeah, you can take on like contracts for like if you really need money. Yeah, 5. That's not terrible. 7. Another 5. A 7. Okay. All right. 5, 7, 5, 7. It's not terrible. So I think we have to make like $1 million before we get to the next. Like office. I think this, yeah, hold on, this is gonna be our best one yet. Werewolf action. It's gonna cost us 80,000 to buy the license, but we're gonna do it. Call it Werewolf Attack. I don't know where I pulled that one from. That was insane. Was it that bad? No. Come on, it wasn't that bad. Come on. Stock market sim. 2008. Alright, here come the reviews.
Here comes the money!
Here we go!
Money talks!
Here comes the money! Money!
Alright. Okay, alright. Yeah, if we can make another stock market sim, I think we'd be pretty good. Stealing shit sim. Thief action for the 64. Yeah. What was it? Level design's gotta be like super important. Alright, here come the reviews. If this isn't like a perfect game, I don't know. I don't know what it is. Okay, alright, never mind. We're gonna call it Crypto Scammer. Crypto Scammer. Super Crypto Scammer Bros. All right, here we go. It's a perfect game. 10. It's a 10. It's a 10. Okay. It's a 9. I'll take a 9. What was the other one that did really well? Hunting in action or something like that, right? Animal Trickshot World. I'm Steve O'Connell, reporter for Planet GG. We've heard a rumor that your company is developing a game for mature audiences. Will you be willing to give an interview about this? Yes. Great, thank you for your time. We'll publish the interview next week. Oh, we got hype. Most games are being hyped up. There's no way. I thought I was going to get a 1 right off the bat. I would have actually cried. Young. Vocabulary. Strategy. For the TES. Name it. Words are awesome. I know the obvious thing is, make it text-based. No, because you can't type on the Nintendo. Okay, yeah, here it is. If you have more than 1 million in cash, you'll be able to move out. This will sound like a lot, but don't worry. Once you release a hit game, you'll get to this amount easily. That's what I'm saying. Okay, here's the reviews. Okay. 10? Perfect 10? Okay, maybe it just wasn't for you. You know that? Maybe it's just not for you. Every game on Steam nowadays. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Go to any Steam chart. It's fucking top 5 is one of those games. You know what I'm talking about. No way. Alright, we're moving out. We're moving out. We're making our $300,000. Feels good. Yeah, no, alright. We won. Alright, we won. 1 million! Pay 150k. Get out of here. Get out of the garage. There we are. We're in our new office now.